Oh boy. Final live stream. Speaking of live, am I live? Chap's not showing me he's live. Oh, okay, I am. Alright. There we go. Everything's good now. This is gonna be the final live stream. I grinded a bit off stream last night. Everyone is at like 29, or 29, 1 to 8, 19 now. Bogo's 19. Sundown is 21. Zinshan Kwan, or Lee, what's her name? I can't remember her actual name. She's at level 22. Cube does not level up at all. He's stuck at level 7 forever. But it turns out that there are certain accessories, like the Plasma Spark, which just flat out gives him new moves. Like, he knows Plasma Spark now. Also, every power part that I farmed gave him 10 HP. So now he has the second most HP in the party. Right behind Pogo, who has, like, an ungodly high amount. So Cube's gonna be good, because he's gonna be, like, our tanky healer. He's gonna be able to take damage, and he's gonna heal distance. Well, not distance, but he heals like a 3x3 square, including himself. So that's really useful. Also, we're going to get him as attack piece, because he's the only dungeon left, and then we'll be good to go. Well, actually, there's some hidden bosses first, but we'll tackle those as we come along to them. I also checked how many runs I had before fighting the hidden boss. It turns out 6. One more run, and I get the dialogue for it. So we're going to be seeing, like, all the cool, like, endgame stuff today. Also, I can pretty much beat every enemy that comes along now without any trouble. Like, we all remember how annoying this battle was yesterday. It turns out this move just completely eradicates everything. So let's just have Cube waste some turns here. We could do this. Doesn't work on every enemy, but it works on a lot of them. Also, I'm getting, like, no experience from these fights now, because I'm so over-leveled at this point. Like, 30 is apparently, like, the highest you're supposed to go, period. And my entire team's at level 20 now. And I haven't even gone to the final dungeon yet. Also, you might be seeing a lot of these enemies just because apparently that's what it scaled my level to, which doesn't make sense. It's weird, like, the characters you have sort of determine the enemies that appear, as well as your levels. But it's weird, because this is, like, a really low-level encounter for what my current stats are. So this will use, I got everyone's ultimates, because level 16 is where you get their ultimate. Hurricane Shot, and then she'll use, Zhan, Ya, Lian, Shang Quan. He will become a lot more useful once I get the part for him, I think. We'll do his dungeon first, just to get that over with. probably just leads up to the other staircase. The other house, rather. Akira just goes back to sleep. Really? I knew it. You need my help. Nah. Later, then. I'll be crashing here. I could theoretically de-equip the other three party members and give all their strongest shit to us, but, I've been told that that's not exactly a smart idea. Welcome to the Labyrinth of Intelligence. I'm the intelligence of Cube. Strength is unnecessary here. Lateral thinking and a calm composure will guide your mind to a new level. This chair will connect us from here on out. Speak to the chair, and I will come. Okay. We got it. The first test lies ahead. Rearrange the red floor. First width, then height. Both at last. Height? Good job. Good job, me. Whoa. Okay. My controls got all friggy there. Alright, so standing on these red tiles reverses your controls. Yeah, that's what it looks like. Well, it changes your left and right, but not your up and down. That changes your left and right. Oh god, this one actually... Wait, no, never mind. Oh, this completely warps your, directions. Holding my controller the opposite direction. I'm gonna Wiimote this shit. Oh. This is the Chamber of Mirrors. Follow your image in the mirrors and a white sphere will show you the way. Speak to me if you wish to restart the test. Well, did I finish what was in the other room? Something tells me I'm not completely grasping what to do here. Also, this room is just looping endlessly, I think. Oh, alright. Apparently there's no real puzzle here. It's just get to the end. That's not the end. Follow your image in the mirrors and a white sphere will show you the way. Talk to me if you wish to restart the chest. So Cube's looking right. So right. Right. Up. 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 Left. Left. Up. Hey. Alright. One of your reflections will guide you forward, the other will lead you astray. try left. Up. Up. Left. That was right the first time, sorry. Up. Up. Chose right. Trust not these mirrors. So now it's going to be whichever one I'm not looking at is the direction to go to. So, down. Don't go left. Don't go up, down. Go right. Don't go left or right. Don't go up. Go down. Or don't go down. Go up. Okay. Now go left. Now go... Wait. We're just walking in a circle here. Yeah, we gotta go down. We gotta go right. We gotta go up. And we gotta go, yeah. And then we gotta go down, and then down again. Okay. Now go right. Now go right again. Now go right again. Go up. What? Alright, that didn't work. That means go down, so go up here. Now go left. Up. And up. Right. 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 Up. Pressing ahead is not the only answer. Sometimes to move forward, you must turn back. Up. Up. Down. Okay, down again. Up. Up. It's really easy. Welcome to the corridor of time. Oh, hey, Chrono Trigger shout out. At its terminus, you shall ascend. This is the final test. Here too shall the spheres guide. In time, you shall find understanding. In time, huh? Is that really it? That was pretty easy. Got 17 diode. And now we're back where I started this chapter. 17 diode gives him 30 attack, 10 spirit, and another 50 IQ. So I found out the numbers on the bottom aren't your total stats, it's the stat plus or minus what's next to it. So, Cube has 149 IQ, which is pretty ridiculous. 30 power, 60 spirit, and 101 vitality, which is pretty good, it's pretty balanced. There's actually a hidden boss in Cube's dungeon now, too. So we'll do... We're actually ready to go to the end now. But, we're gonna fight the hidden bosses first. Or what we can of them, at least. Hopefully not all of them will cause trouble. We'll do Pogo's, since it's near here. We'll do the, death thing, which is run from 5 more battles. Or 6, rather. Like, I actually checked, and this, I was 1 away. Coward. Running away. 5 more times. We're gonna head to Pogo's dungeon up there as well to fight that fish or whatever. These enemies are a pain in the ass. I don't even want to fight them if I don't have to. 4 more times. Three more times. Titan Brad. I actually have no clue what that thing is. I fought it once and it was went down really easily. 2 more times. Once more. You have fled 100 times. I am the harbinger of doom. Harbinger of doom. You cannot escape when I have been called. I don't know if you fight him every 100 times you flee or just the 100th time. And that's it. Death Prophet. Petrify Sphere? Shit. Oh wait, can Cube not be petrified though? Nah, he can't. Dimensional Rift. Ooh, that hurt. That hit. Oh, he used one of her moves. Ah, shit, she's stunned. That's why bringing Pogo into this, or Cube into this battle is pretty good. Because he can't get stunned. Look at that, 900 damage. Dead. Got aerial mail. The aerial items are apparently like the biggest, like the final game armor. Also, I figured out how to skip that black screen glitch. It's just literally tap the button. Aerial mail, plus 20 defense. Who needs it the most? Well, who's got the lowest defense? Pogo. Now he's beefed. Also, I don't think there's any penalty for running now, which is good, because there's not a lot of battles I want to do left. Titan Brad and a bunch of pistachios. Actually, I might try to do this fight, just because, that's a lot of, that's a lot of power part potential there. Ah, oh, they all broke down. Shit. Never mind. If I found out if an enemy breaks down, you don't get any potential drops off of it. And all those pistachios have the potential to drop a power part for Cube. Wait a minute. That didn't work the way I wanted it to. Thought the pistachios only had like 20 health. Oh god, everyone's getting... Let's just get out of here. I don't really think Cube needs any more power-ups at this point. This is the one I usually fight. These two and then that thing. But what do I usually use on them that actually kills them? It isn't Hurricane Shot. I thought it was Shot Storm, but it doesn't feel like that's, like, gonna kill them anymore. Power parts, and another power parts. Good. Each one can drop a power part. Pump Cube up, he's got 680 HP now. Dimensional Genzeimon. I haven't fought these guys yet. And there they go. I got tequila from them. Zinshan Quan is level 23. Let's save before doing this. What, you got something you want to say to me? Is that so? Then you have a gold top knot? Somewhere in here I do. There it is. That's the stuff. Thanks a bunch. Can I help you with something else? Is there something you want to ask me? Yeah. It'll cost you a lot. Let's see. How about your soul? Yeah. Time to die. I'm Lucretia. Ultimate technique. Which now you can use unlimited times. That didn't do a lot of damage. He has to hit multiple times for that to do a lot. Stop going after her! It's two shots. Could be better though. And she's done. Yeah, the big fish is actually also a hidden boss in Poseidon's Whip. There's also a big fish boss in Aboros Chapter 2. I can't, it's poison. There we go. Why did he do a lot? Oh, it's lowering his stats every time he does. Shit. That luck base on that is, like, terrible. A better item? Meaty Bone? Alice Biscuit? It's only a one. Stella? Area Great Deal. There we go. He just heals as a counter. It's amazing. He could use a self-heal. Very good. A boom boom. It's actually pretty decent. Got him. Sundown is level 22. Mermaid bottom found. Yeah, fish please. You're pretty strong. You can have this. Got aerial ring. But the golden topknot is mine. I won't give it back. Anyways, a promise is a promise. What do you want to know? Who are you? I'm Lucretia, and I'm the older than the history of Lucretia itself. Oh, I'm Lucretia. That's what it is. I've lived so long, I've nearly become a god myself. I'm not sure why, but all the humans disappeared from around here some time back. It's kind of weird, but at least it's quiet, you know? I do feel some kind of presence in the southeast, but I don't know whether or not it's human. Is there something you want to ask? Where am I? This is the Dungeon of Instinct. Only those with a strong, wild nature may pass into it. There are also dungeons of power, intelligence, technique, mind, time, and keys. What do you mean, how do I get in? What a question. Use your little lazy bones. What do I look like, a strategy guide? Fine, I'm sure you could do it. Found your way here, after all. Besides, your drive to achieve is what makes you human. Who's that? You have nothing. Who am I? What the hell kind of question is that? How should I know if you don't? Okay then, see ya. Mermaid bottom. Lowers speed a bit, but raises defense and IQ. He already has the mermaid bottom. Nah, I could really do with a higher speed. He already has the mermaid bottom. Aerial ring. It's really hard to tell if any of these things do. Seems to have the same effect as the Chow Chow, which is, plus 10... to vitality. Probably gives another bonus. Let me check. Aerial ring. Petrify immunity. Fire armor evade up. Charge skill evade up. Earth skill evade up. Wow, so pretty much just makes you a beast at not getting hit. You know, Sundown can really use that because, let's see, is there anything else that can be replaced that gives him better stats as a result? Peacekeeper badge. What exactly does the Peacekeeper badge even do? Fire armor evade up. Yeah, fuck that. I know that was, like, important to his chapter, but it's not necessary now. So that's two bosses down. Let's get out of here. I love killing these things. They drop healing items. Two hidden bosses down. I think the next one is in Cube's dungeon. There it is. I saw it. Sneak, being all sneaky-deaky up there. The diode. Is it you who have usurped the mind of the ancient god Erox? That's weird. Like, Eroquus I can understand, but Erox is weird. I feel like the Q should be the first. Missile launcher. Ow. Completely missed. Come on, dude. Alright, I clearly am not going into this the right way. Make your way back to the dungeon until you find your ox. That's not. I'll be on the third level. My cube's attacks will be particularly useful, so keep them using high speed up. Everyone wants to use their best attacks. Well, my best attacks aren't hitting, so. Hey, there we go. Finally got a hit on him. What the hell? There we go. Ooh, he's almost dead too. He only has 658 HP apparently. And he's dead. I thought the diode was safely sealed away. God, I just hear the Mario RPG sound effects there. Got aerial helm. I kind of want to play that, actually, but oh my god, I'm so burnt out in RPGs. Or I will be. Hey Kai, what's up? I'm pretty good. Aerial helm. More IQ, less defense. That gives him more defense. More defense. Who needs the most? And Shan Kwan needs the most, so I'll give it to her. Dun, dun, dun. Let's see, did I get all the aerial equipment? Let me just check, because it looks like I've actually done everything. Aerial helm. Ring. Oh, I have to fight one of that boss from inside Sundown's dungeon if I want the last piece of aerial equipment. I could attempt that if I really want to. Yeah, and the last piece of equipment is in the last area. Okay. So killing Sundown's boss is the only thing left, really. Which is weird, because that one's actually like a requirement if you don't clear that dungeon fast enough. Power parts. That cube has 700 HP, which is pretty cool. I think he's pretty close to becoming the highest HP party now. I guess I could go look. Wait, what? Is there something over here? Algos's eye. That's right, I didn't get all the treasure chests on my other visit here. That's all of them, actually. Yep. See where I'm going. Yeah. Delicious. You look absolutely delicious. Dance for me. Jaggies. Down. Ooh. Ooh, good, that hits both of them. Ah, Pogo's down. What? Laser Sonic? Oof. Oh, Pogo's down. Got the aerial glove. Man, I would never have been able to do that dungeon. Or beat those guys if this was the first round. Or the first dungeon I did, rather. So I get the aerial glove. Lowers my... gives me some shitty IQ, but raises my defense a bit. Time to see what the aerial glove actually does. Petrify immunity. Ah, well, Cube doesn't need that. She's the one who's going to be getting close to people, probably. Well, never mind. Whatever. So we've officially done everything outside the final dungeon now. If I come along with you? Nah. Well, my apologies then. It's like, I'll just chill in this land I know nothing about. If I'm not mistaken, I needed the sword from the grave to do this. Looks like all the items are still gone. Which was probably... Tumblebug. Which is probably not a smart idea on my part, because there probably were going to be better items for me now. Surprisingly easy. Horror ship. If I'm not mistaken, I read that these guys can drop, power parts. Which is good. A couple extra HP for Cube won't hurt. Wow, this thing has a lot of HP. Probably should have checked. Pogo needs to... I should probably put Pogo in the front. Just in the front two spots, just because, he does not have very good range with his attacks. Whatever, it was enough. No power parts, though. It sucks. Yeah, I found out you could just waste turns by spinning with the L and R buttons. We're looking on level ups. Not close. He can't level up. He'll go reach level 20 soon. At least, that's good. Fighting that thing again. Not worth it. Each character should have one piece of aerial equipment. Aerial. No, she has two. Home back on her. Probably because the aerial helms all give extensive amounts of immunities. Actually, wait, why would I give Cube the air? Wait, hold on. Petrify, I mean, he can't get petrified. There's no point. Like, otherwise this dungeon's completely straightforward. It's completely the same as before. Yeah, all the items are gone because I took them already in the last chapter. If I didn't, apparently they'd be way better now. Which kind of sucks, but whatever. Otherwise this dungeon's exactly the same, so it's just head straight to the end. Let's try something here, because they say use a noise stream, and it'll take them all out quickly. I think it's going to count. All of them are going to counter, so let's just speed through that. God, it didn't kill them all. Yeah, the Hell Fragrance does not do a lot of damage, but it inflicts you with, like, every status ailment possible. But since Cube's a robot, he can't get inflicted with most of them. Oh, he got inflicted with sleep, though. High speed gel bullet, yeah. Unicorn horn, power parts. Ah, just one for killing all those, really? accessories. Dead ends in this dungeon. I don't know what the point of the tumble bug is. Man, I want to sit through all those animations again, just for one power part. Done for that one. I guess it only... This is Lee. Odie Wang Lee? Dio. That's weird. That statue wasn't in that position last time. The last time this one was. I have the two party members that don't speak, so there's two references that just don't come up. That's weird, though. This statue of Odio was definitely up here, and this one of the Great Inko Buddha was down in the middle before. In fact, that seems to be the only one that's changed in this chapter. Maybe it's because my party leader is Sundown, and that's why it's in the middle. So whoever's your party leader, it switches. So I'm assuming that means that Akira is supposed to be like the canon party, main party member, which kind of sucks because he's the worst. He's one of the worst party members in the game, apparently. Examine the statue now. Go downwards, down towards the staircase, and you will appear. I'll have to actually go and absorb the statue of him. Alright. So there's a hidden boss here too, apparently. I've been waiting for you. My name is Odio, King of Demons. Yeah, about that. We're gonna peace out. Later. You cannot escape. From my world. Yeah, I think now we're back in this void area from the beginning. You lost child from another dimension. I fling you into the world of death. Head plucker. Alright, apparently what he'll do is he'll have an attack which... he'll use people adjacent to him, which instantly kills him with, like, a con over 99. Ooh, that sucks. There we go. He's losing stats. Hold those down. Oh, come on. A single shot. Fuck. I think I lost. Yep, I'm dead. Shit. I'm not finishing this without Tiff killing this guy. Good. Actually good, though. Only doing 79 damage. There we go. Got him. Pogo's level 20. Nice. Got the aerial boots. We're back here now. So we're back here again, which means I have to go to the final dungeon once more. But whatever, it was worth it to get those boots and fight that final boss. Let's see if I can take this out easier now. That is a pain in the ass. I don't even care, it just takes so long. Didn't even get a single power point from that power part, power part, fuck. Real boots. Defense, but no, that's not really good for him, actually. Actually, wait. Maybe there is a piece of Genji aerial equipment that's good for him. For Cube, just because he could still fall asleep. Petrify. 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 Nightmare Helmet gives sleep immunity. Okay. Worth it. All the aerial equipment gives Petrify immunity, apparently, which is really important for the last battle. Thank you. These are new enemies, but whatever. I don't care. Limber skill. Alright, you know what? If I kill you, we'll make you stop spawning every 2 steps. HP. That's a Boros move. Sundown is level 23. Nice. No one's gonna learn anything new. All the ultimate techniques are 16. I think random battles have outstayed their welcome at this point. Does Pogo have 900 HP at level 20? Wow, yeah, 21. Waiting for you. You already saw this. My name is Odio, King of Demons. Welcome. I've called each of you here to ask you some very, very important questions. Heroes each of you may be, but what has the rest of humanity done for you? All anyone has ever done is ask for your help. They distance themselves from harm and rely on others to save them. Are such people even deserving of help in the first place? That is my first question. My second question, for each of you individually. Why? What is the reason for your fight? Why do you continue? To protect the weak? You may be right. Very well. You've all been victorious in your self-important battles. Self-important and indeed selfish. Is it right to hurt others to achieve your own ends, no matter how important? You're all the same as the maggots that lived in this realm, just like them. Say goodbye to this sinful life of pain and woe. Oh, that's a good noise. Real good. Oh. Odio Eye. Odio Mole. Odio Mouth. Jesus. I'm being told not to hit the mole, like, under any circumstances. So this is like Kefka. Body parts on the bottom, and you can see Odio's on the very top, above the mole. Death versus space, what? Life Eraser. Oh, geez. That's one eye down. Don't erase life. You can't erase Cube's life. He's mechanical. Also, the eyeball somehow turned around. I only did two shots. This eye's really weird. Those lips are weird, too. Also, that thing at the top is definitely a bird, but it's called the Odio Mole for some reason. Why did I bring... Man, I don't know why I decided Pogo was a good choice. These attacks kind of suck. I'm assuming that stun that turns them to stone, because that's not doing a lot of damage. Phase 2, which phase 1 was barely a challenge at all. Pure Odio. Oh shit. Cancel Ray. Let me guess, anyone that's in the middle of an attack gets canceled. Saint Alicia. Oh god, what the hell is this? Ooh, that hurt and it put him to sleep. Creepy. Yes! Oh, that was such a good hit. Wow, so I took almost half his health with that one bullet storm. Ah, shit. Shit, was that it? Yep. It was like no problem for Sundown. He was just like, I got a gun. I can kill demons. You win. Now, finish me. Apparently, depending on the end, whichever choice I picked changes the ending. So, I'm actually going to save state here, so I don't have to redo that. If we choose to finish, we get a decent ending. And if we choose no, then we get the true ending. Alicia. Adios. Damn. A pretty truncated ending there. Also, apparently if you lose to Odio, it just automatically does the Armageddon ending from if you choose Orsted for the final chapter. This is the same music, yeah, I think it's that song. It's the same music that plays for Orsted's ending if you beat his version of the final chapter, like legit, without using Armageddon. Time spun on forever and ever. ... I don't know, I think that last song was glitched. Yeah, I'm not doing that battle all over again, so let's load game from there. Finish me. No. Now, finish me. Oh, you could just actually stop there and save. Thank you. Sorry we're late. We're here. Now, suppose if you don't have, of course, if you don't have all seven party members, like, and their dungeons beaten, then this kind of gets, like, shortened, and the true ending is just shorter. It's not over yet. Even if I'm beaten, I'll keep on living. You must know the meaning of Odio. From ancient times. Until the distant future. Eras of peace. Eras of war. In all places. And all times. And the impetus of conflict. Eternal sentiment that will not die as long as there are humans to perpetrate it. It is hatred. It is odio. Like odious, I guess. Now I get it. I want to go back. To my own world. Partner. It's like this is the most he's talked in the entire game. Actual boss rush time. Somebody's speaking to the comm unit. Everything on this ship must work in harmony. I was built to maintain. It's this all this dialogue again. Odio is Latin for hatred. Alright. I mean, that's probably where the term odious comes from. Sammo Huon, watch me. Zinshan Quan's final technique. Ha, foolish child. Zuan Ya Lian Shan Quan. There you are. Over here. Behold, tower before the sublime form of he who shall rule the land of the rising sun. I fucked that line up again. Bad Masaru. You're such a tiny man. Your determination is admirable. I'm displeased. I'm not impressed, though. The competition was not exactly stellar. I gave them quick deaths. First was that amateur Namcat and the Lucha Wimp. I twisted Tula's joints in ways nature never intended. Then Max and that fat-ass Uakia. And that geezer, whatever his name was. They were weak, so they died. Now you fight me. Odie Oldbright. Son of a bitch. You didn't fight them. You just slaughtered them. Namcat's Ashiwaza, Great Asia's Lucha, Tula's arms lock, Jackie's strength, Morgan's power, Seishi's technique, and my anger. I'll crush you. You've come. Now, the great Inko Buddha statue shall bring unto us salvation. Master Odio arrives. Stay calm. We could do this. Right, Matsu? You're the one who wasted Pike. Doesn't matter how many rats you rustle up, you won't be able to win against a Gatling gun. So he's still doing this. Spin drive was what was able to kill him last time. It's the only one he doesn't respond to a heal with. Oh, never mind. Okay. Oh, it was mind hack, okay. Seems to be random now, because he's not responding to a Mazer Cannon with heal. Maybe it's just use ultimate techniques until they die. I think that's it. Just use ultimate techniques twice. Which I probably don't have for him. Also, now I think it's going in a chronological order. Oh, actually, no, it started in the future. Kind of going in a weird random order. Yeah, the narrative is that you're supposed to hack into it. It took me a long time to figure that out. This pain in the ass. Remember, I just barely beat this one. Remember how much trouble this guy gave me? This was like the one I lost the most against. But unlike the other bosses, you were just given a continue option right afterwards. I want to play a Robot Wars game, which I actually do have planned. I had a Robot Wars J planned for some point in the future, but it's going to be a long game. And those games kind of get boring quickly, so that probably wouldn't be like a solitary game stream. It would be something I'd play like in between other games. One hit and he's down. Why can't I win? Isn't this my destiny? What is the difference between you and I? Of course, I too am running away from other people, and am always roaming. But all of that wandering, all that time being alone, makes for you long for a little companionship every once in a while. Yeah, essentially, my gun has turned into a Gatling gun. You're right. All that time hating humans and being alone. It's made me realize, like, how his font is going between his font and the demon font. I, too, am human. When I die, you will all be able to return to your own worlds. But, don't forget, anyone can become a king of demons, as long as hatred still exists in any world at any time. I think he's actually dead now. Shit. Yeah, he's dead. Sad ending for Orsted. Don't forget. Anyone could become a king of demons. As long as hatred still exists in any world at any time. I just said that. Thank you, Gramps. I have faith that dawn will always break through the dark of night. Love. It's the only word he knows, somehow, even though there was no words back when he existed. I'll continue my quest to be the strongest. I'm happy enough. At least I have a place to go home to. And so life goes on. Yeah, the world's back to normal, but the people are all still dead, so... They had a kid, a baby, a Babu caveman. And the monkey had kids with all the other monkeys. Unbelievable. Cube and his owner are happy. Another guy learned to accept robots, I guess. And everyone else on their crew is still dead. She starts teaching other kids, which kind of not surprising, since she's supposed to teach the art to other people. I thought this game was going to end with them all being stuck in the past together. That would have sucked. I wonder how many noise complaints Masaru gets. Probably a lot, that's why he was moving out. Oh, that flashing. The real reason I picked Sundown is because he's the hardest character to recruit. You have to talk to him like 9 times in 9 different areas to actually recruit him. What are you doing up there? Having a wrestling match? As a matter of fact, yes. Pretty good ending. It wasn't like most of the like oh shit moments come in the chapter before this one when you're playing as Orsted and you realize like how shitty his life turns out, but it's still pretty solid all around. Definitely a good precursor to Chrono Trigger. Just in time for the credits, yeah. Don't worry, I'm not done with it yet. We've still got a few more things I want to do before I stop playing it that I missed out on. I gotta say, for as frustrating as it was, tonight's stream made up for it, because tonight's stream was incredibly easy. Each part a different style. That's because there was a different artist handling like the character designs and stuff for each part, which is kind of cool. And again, that's kind of makes me think of Chrono Trigger, because like you had each of these artists doing a chapter of this game, and then you had Akira Toriyama doing Chrono Trigger afterwards. So it's kind of like he's like another chapter of this game, and to an extent, just a much better chapter. Chrono Trigger is a really good game. See, this game I played now and I feel dated. Chrono Trigger I played when it came out in the DS for the first time, and it didn't feel dated back then, because it felt like a new game to me. don't know what I'm going to stream next, actually. Probably not another RPG, just because I need a break. I'm already doing Bravely Second and two Fire Emblem games off stream, so... kind of need a break from that. Also, I wish I had a way to stream from my TV. But at the same time, I know I'm not going to want to stream Zelda next month, because that's going to be a game that I'm going to be playing, like, all the time. Anything that's open world, I'm probably not going to be streaming. Pretty good ending. The end. Couple ammo. And I guess it's just whoever you picked for the as the starting character for the other end, for the title screen. And that's the end. Yep. But we are not done yet. No. I made this file before just to get a little revenge on Captain Square. So it turns out the password for this, I almost got it right, because I was putting in like all different quotes related to him. Yeah, the portrait was really detailed. It's the same portrait that appears on the art. If you look at the box art, there's portraits for each of the seven main characters, and that's the one that appeared for the sundown at the end. So this guy's password is warp. I put in, like, an abbreviation of warp speed, thinking that was the password, but apparently it's just warp. I sleep below your feet. Got a memory card. So, what the memory card allows me to do is allows me to save in Captain Square. I can also reformat it and make it so I don't, I start the beginning again. But we're gonna get some revenge on Captain Square here. Heading board. Hey, knocked me right where I needed to be. Thank you. Like, juggled me right into position. Diagonal is the best way to take him out. Stop it. Okay, I'm making the dumbest choice here. Yeah. Oh, there's been some frame drops. Shit. I think that's stopping, though. Come on, move him one square closer. Shit! Really? That thing wasn't supposed to do that till the end? Alrighty, I'm back to getting fucked on this stage. Come on, Aqua Flare. There we go. Spin a bunch. There we go. Now we can take the rest of them out. Oh, don't shrimp me. I've been shrimped. Oh, they're all about shrimping. Oh my god, how long does this move to take a charge? Right on. Mm-hmm. Are these the birds that move left and right? Cybirds. Yeah, they're alien eagles, Epsilon eagles, cousins. Wasn't a smart idea. Ah, man, what a fucking rip. I gotta do that mission over. Be nice. Don't move. There we go. There we go. Saturn. These things again. Remember these things? They kill me instantly. So I should use Plasma Ball on this one. That was a stupid move. This is where I died last time. Now they're different positions. So two spaces up from where they are, or down. Nope, that was dumb of me. Should've went around. Heal a bunch. There we go. Next stage, Uranus, with that guy who's imprisoned. Electric Mirage. Pimuri. What? Cool. Yeah, well, guess what, Firefield? Disorienting as hell. Disable the foreground layer? Wait, what? Oh, what do you know? It just lets you see all the enemies, but I mean, it's not that hard to see them. So they just keep multiplying, it's only the thing in the center that needs to be killed. Though I should probably eliminate the fire, or get the fire in the middle first. Thank you. Maybe it doesn't matter. What? Wow. There we go. Oh. Okay, cool. Yeah, what the hell? That's kind of lame. Neptune, Lalu, and a Lala. I'm guessing the one that's named differently is the one that has to get killed. Okay. Final stage, Pluto. Polka dot Q, polka dot R, polka dot Z, polka dot X. Cool. Luck plays a major part of this battle, just use Pi Mason or Plasma Ball. Great. Oof. You just really can't be aligned, like, to get hit. Yeah, that's kind of sucky. They cover every square of the field here. I'm gonna have to take a few out before I can start using the shot. Okay, wait, there might actually be space here where they don't cover. I'm like literally counting the squares here. Right here, possibly. Nope, that one up there was able to do it. Shit. Aww. Wasn't good enough. I don't hope suicide. Yeah, I got lucky there. Not so lucky there, though. Oh, that one gets healed from electricity. Which one got me from there, though? Still got him. He's in range. These things are cute but deadly. Completely missed. Come on. One more down. No, don't. At least I'm out of his range now. Thank you. What? No! You've gotta be... What was that shit? What the fuck was that? There. Jesus. Sweet Jesus. You just realized what I was calling me A? Yeah, it's because I named Cube A in this chapter. Exploded, but it didn't kill me. No! No, you bastard! Oh my god! Imagine not knowing about the memory card, coming all this way and then failing on this stage. That would suck. Why? I was one step away from doing it. No! Stop for like a second so I could do this. See, that time it didn't break my concentration. Oh, good. I have no health left. ass. Please, stay away. Good, got him in position. Got him. Oh, thank God. It's over. Oh, neat. It has its own, like, little credits thing. That's cool. Design H Snippy amount of 550,000 cane. Captain Square, the Big Ben Eater. Okay. Bookstore John. Music composer, Rainbow the Joker. This is all fake credits. Presented by Aromatsoft, $20.99. Hey, this game comes out 72 years from now. It's amazing how far video games come. That's that. That's literally all you get from it. Formatted memory card. Current data will be erased. And it's gone. If you choose no, then it just starts you from the last stage every time. That's actually pretty much it. Well, it for me. There's a couple more things I was going to show off before I stop. Just reset. Let's save state. Because that is the end of the game. But I did have a few videos that I found that show off some stuff that I missed. And since I'm going to end the stream in, like, now anyway, there's, like, no time left, I might as well just show them. So, first is... Hold on. So I missed two Watanabe death story in the game. I missed the wrestler and the kung fu chapters. So what I'll do is unlabel desktop sharing. Ooh, nice. And I'll just show these videos. They're like all by the same guy, so it won't be too big of a deal. So this is really quick. This is the wrestler one. You literally lure this guy up into the corner, into the bottom right, and eventually someone will throw a can at him, and then he goes out and kills him, and that's it. And that's implied to be Watanabe for this time period. Here's the Kung Fu one. So that happens when you have the female successor. When you have the large guy, Sammo is successor, though, this scene happens too. Little one, do you realize what sort of place this is? You've forgotten me already? You're Wantong Kung Fu's. Ha! Huh. I've been waiting for this. My father's death will have not been in vain. See, Wantong Kung Fu, like Watanabe. I've trained hard to learn the special move. You'll feel my wrath. This is Wantong Kung Fu's final breath. Ultra Miracle Special Smash. Ah! And just blows up in his face. So it's not actually a Watanabe death, he's already dead. But the son fails at avenging him. This is annotated. Let's turn this off. This is actually a different person. I'll link to them when I put this on YouTube. I'll link back to their videos. There's actually, wow, this is loud. Hold on. Oh, it, like, glitched out. What the fuck? Let's lower that a bit. So this is apparently the two hidden bosses that you could fight, I think. Wait, is this one of them? In the ninja chapter, there's two of them. Also, he kept the copy robot. You cannot have this blade. Leave this place at once. If you not leave, you will die. So it's just a more powerful samurai. Wow, this guy's emulator is not very good. Yeah, it's actually possible to keep that clone of you from the ninja chapter longer. Yeah, I'm not gonna watch this whole thing, because this, it's getting annoyingly loud. I think that's how you get one of the ultimate weapons, the Muramasa. Something's been scratching aside. Goyamon was here. Ugh, that sound quality is terrible. So the other hidden boss is, there's a part where you apparently go into a river here, and if you go up here, there's if you look right there, there's an easier version of the fish from later, Lord Iwama. This one you can apparently fight without killing anyone. He flops around, he hurts you, blah blah blah, yada yada yada. This fight goes on for a while still. Thank you.
burglar.
I don't think you get anything for that, though. But yeah, that's pretty much it. There's nothing else really to show here. There's my background, which I'll now be disabling. So yeah, that's pretty much Live Alive. There's nothing else much to say about it. You saw all of it. It was fun. I definitely would not go back and play it again anytime soon. Unlike Chrono Trigger, which I could like play every year. Because that game is just amazing. But it's cool to see what Chrono Trigger was kind of like influenced by. And how it became what it was from this game. Also, Secret of Mana, I think, too, had a lot of influence on Chrono Trigger. I think a lot of Chrono Trigger's content is based off of unused stuff in Secret of Mana. Which is pretty cool. Still have to play Seiken Densetsu 3 someday. And that might happen, but not anytime soon, because I need a break from RPGs. I don't know when I'm going to stream next, and I actually don't even know when I'm going to stream yet. But, you know, that'll hopefully be next week. I don't know, probably won't stream this weekend. Maybe I will. Maybe I'll do a Sunday afternoon stream, I'm not sure. But I'm done for now. I need to get going. I'm going to rest up a bit, because today was kind of a thing. But it's cool. Anyway, thanks for coming by, guys. I'll see you around. You have a good night.